generally are concentrated only for targeted pests, and they do not harm the other pests which are not supposed to be targeted. For example, for the plants. Third, biopesticides are often effective in very small quantities and often decompose quickly.
Here we have manure. When we see this word manure, we come to know about the natural substance or natural fertilizer. It is obtained by decomposition of animal waste, excreta such as dung of cattle and buffalo and plant residues. First, regular income and year-round employment provides food and nutritional security. Eco-recycling of the agricultural waste. Fourth is better soil quality for sustainable agriculture with minimization of pollution hazards. Improves microclimate. Conservation of natural resources. Minimizes the risk of failure in productivity. Here are some components of integrated farming system. First we have sustainable agriculture and organic farming. Then improvement in crop yields, animal husbandry, poultry farming, fish production and beekeeping.
Society people needs good food quality with safety. It needs farmer skill for growing good seeds to produce a good raw material. Rural, social and economic conditions.
It provides food, good food supply. It does not affect the farmer's income and it is responsible for sustainable food products. Environment gives us many things
such as soil, water, air, energy and biodiversity for growing plants and also for animals.
By innovation farming, with the growing years, technology has improved
the total and the optimum use of agricultural practices by using both old and new agricultural practices
in order to maximize sustainable output within the limits of available resources.
Involved in chemical farming and in organic farming, the pH remains neutral. And soil structure is altered in chemical farming, while in organic farming, the soil structure remains intact. Lastly, the soil becomes dead when we chemical farm, but in organic farming, the soil becomes fertile.